Is your home stacked to the ceiling with piles of paper, books, even garbage? Do you have trouble getting rid of that old stuff? Well, you may have developed a condition called pack ratitis. You're not alone, and there is some help. That's the good news. Tava Smiley, host of TLC's Clean Sweep, joins us this morning with advice on how to declutter. Hi, Tava.
Hi, Natalie. How are you?
Good. So I have a pretty good idea what pack ratitis is, but have you officially termed it that?
I'll tell you what, we call people that have a tendency to collect miscellaneous things and then get attached to them and hang on to them and have a hard time letting them go, even though they're not useful anymore, we call those people with pack ratitis. And honestly, two-thirds of our country is full of these people.
What is it? Is it just that we get emotionally attached to things?
You know, that is definitely a very big reason right there. We get sentimentally attached. A lot of times the thing represents the memory. And a great tip is to realize that the thing is not the memory, and you can keep the memory and stop tripping over the thing. But also, I think sometimes we have a financial investment in something, yeah. And we have an idea that we're going to use that thing, or we don't want to let it go because we bought it and then we never found a use for it. And so it's hard to let go. I'm a huge fan of websites like Kijiji.com, which is K-I-J-I-J-I, because this is a place you can go to sell that stuff that you've bought or stuff that's sitting around cluttering up your home and actually make some money back. And I'll tell you, the minute you start lining your pockets with a little money when you start decluttering, it's such a great reward and it's a real incentive to keep going.
So what other advice do you have for people who are having a hard time getting that stuff out the door and then selling it online, whatever it might be? Do you have some tips for them?
Yeah, I'll tell you what, start small. Start with 15 minutes a day. It sounds like not much, but I'll tell you, that 15 minutes can really make a dent in your mess. And just start small also with, say, a countertop or one surface area that you can create a clutter-free zone in. And start with one room, go from the outside in, go from all the surfaces to where when you're walking in the room, eventually it's a clean room. Then go and pull out a drawer, then a cabinet, and finish one room in its entirety before you move on to the next. And it really is addictive once you get going. You also are finding things that you haven't used, and it can be a lot of fun cleaning yourself up. You just have to be ready to let some things go.
You've got a lot of stuff around you there. Do you have a list or maybe just a few items that typically sell very well when you go to either garage sale or sell online?
You know what? Again, the reason I promote the selling online, I'm a big fan of that, is because you have specific buyers that are coming for these things. I think big ticket items, like say I have a couch back here, even a crib. Yeah. A lot of times people hold on to a crib because they think they might have another baby. But if you sell it online, you can make some money back, and then you can go rebuy one online when you do have that other baby and it's not sitting in your way cluttering up your space. You can get to a keyboard like this, could make you an extra $10. But when you come over to this computer, an old laptop, which might to you be obsolete because, you know, you've upgraded to another one, an old laptop could bring in $250.
Wow.
An old desktop could bring in $600. Making that kind of money is huge.
Yeah, once you start doing it, you get good at it, and it's not that big of a deal.
Yeah.
Tava, thanks so much for your time this morning. Some great advice.